Good evening, everyone. This has been a wonderful day, and I was actually looking forward to having a relaxed, chilled out weekend in Bangalore till Rishabh asked me to speak today, and I sat here and made the presentation. So besides the organizers who have done a wonderful job, I also want to give a shout out to Rishabh, because he has been doing a great job of getting young developers into open source. And like 4 years ago, when I was in my second year of engineering, I didn't even want to do engineering at that point. I don't know what I was doing, but I just wrote to Rishabh then in my third semester, and he gave me my first internship. So that was a huge couple of months for me, where I figured out that I want to spend some of my career in open source, and I happened to love it a lot then. So let's get started. I'll talk a little bit about the Discourse project. Many people in the room have been using it for their communities, for their teams, but for those of you who are not familiar with it, it is an open source, 100% open source discussion platform, and you can use it for as a mailing list, as a teamwork tool, as a discussion forum, a chat area, whatever you like. It was started in 2013, and today we're a team of 39, and we're a fully remote company, and we are organic, and we have never had any or seeked out any VC funding. We believe that it enables us to make the decisions that are the best for our users, our product, our customers, and also for us. So just touching a little bit on the tech stack, these decisions were made in 2013, but we are very happy with what we went with. It is, you don't hear of people using like a Rails plus Ember combination. So it is a bit hard for people to find help online, like on Stack Overflow and stuff, because it's not a very popular stack. But we're very happy with it, and it's been going great. Touching up a bit about a little bit on the history of the project. Some of you might have heard of one of our founders, Jeff Atwood. He initially founded Stack Overflow in 2008, and he built it up from the ground up till 2013, where he took a break from it. And so you can see that three founders, one of them is from the US, one of them is from Canada, and one of them is from Australia. So you can already tell that it's going to be a fully online remote company. So Stack Overflow, while doing a Stack Exchange, while doing a great job of Q&A, and it also helped people find the fastest answer ASAP. It wasn't that great for discussion, and that wasn't even the point of the product. So our founders were very interested in the forum space, because the discussions would be less like that, and would be more like this, where everyone, it's inclusive, and everyone's talking to everyone, and you have a space for all your members to collaborate. So in 2013, this is what online forums looked like. So they really wanted to fix that. So they wanted it to look different. This, another example could be this. And like, that's just so noisy. We've all grown up, like at least in I've grown up spending a lot of time on the XDA forums and messing with our phones and stuff. But as much as fun it was fun because of the people there, but the site just looks so bad. So that was the initial motivation in 2013. Then, so the goal for the new project in 2013 was to focus on asynchronous, civilized, and long-form communication. So one of the goals is like to just make the internet a better place. The value of people, just humans writing well-thought paragraphs to each other instead of, you know, knee-jerk reactions, and just, you know what I'm talking about, like how Twitter and stuff works these days, and it's just not civilized. And just the value of getting people to write paragraphs to each other and like keeping stuff asynchronous and long form. So that was the initial goal, and now we have the current Discourse platform that looks somewhat like this. So a little bit, touching a little bit about on our fully remote team. So we're 39 employees, and we work from 18 different countries and 14 different time zones. We are fully remote and we've never ever had a central office. And you must be wondering how we manage all of this work ourselves. So we use Discourse itself as our primary team coordination tool to plan all our work. We do use a secondary chat software to, you know, find out when things are on fire and talk to people in private. But the company runs on Discourse. And this is because Discourse excels at asynchronous and distributed teamwork. So you can just, like, in a normal team, you can keep, like, instant messaging, calls, and meetings. These are synchronous things that require your 100% attention. So we keep that to a minimum. This is an old picture of our team when we were just 36. But that is how we're spread out across all time zones. You can see the Indians, like, there are three Indians on the team. So we're there. And yeah, bad. So again, so while we have so many skilled employees, how do we make money? So again, similar to a lot of other companies here, we offer a hosting and support for hosting these forums. So this is just a screenshot of our pricing page where you can see that you have some plans here for like, and then we also make some money from the enterprise plans, which is for communities that do very high traffic and have like special needs. So there's that. And today in 2020, we have about 30,000 GitHub stars, 35,000 commits, 2,000 plus customers that we host ourselves. And yeah, we think there are about 20,000 sites out there, but we're not really sure how to track that. And yeah, so the goal of the Discourse project was to become a standard in online discussion platforms. And we have, while we can't just say that, but we have seen that success in the development community space. These are just companies that are running their community forums on Discourse in the form of community support forums and product development. Like, these are all of these big names are using Discourse right now. We also, like, Shivam also touched upon how the community instance has been doing really well. So I was going to talk about that. And this, they've, I think Frappe have been like early adopters, because I think the site was started in 2015. That's right. So that's the project started. Our project started in 2013. So that's amazing that their site is doing so well. I think Zerodha also has a public instance for their Q&A, which is amazing. This is someone else from this room. And for any open source teams in here, I would recommend trying it out to have your internal team discussions. It is a new use case that has come up in the last few years where people are using Discourse as a teamwork tool to get things done. So I think Frappe has been doing that. They have an internal instance to just making decisions where, because it is really difficult to make like big decisions on something like Slack, right? Like, you can't just type so much and no one is going to read it, and people who are not looking at it then will miss it, things like that. So I would recommend people to give it a shot. We have self-hosted, we have a nice Docker installer for our thing. So it takes like less than 30 minutes to set up. There are these simple instructions. You don't even need to be technical. You just have to follow some instructions and you can set it up with Docker. We also give back to the projects we love. So this is just an example from 2017. That's all I could pull out right now. But so all of the projects we love, we always make it a point to give back to them. Ember.js, Jenkins, Debian, Postgres, and Unicode, Let's Encrypt. So this is just from 2017. I could not find this last year's, but for example, now we are one of the major sponsors for Let's Encrypt, who are doing an amazing job of spreading HTTPS everywhere. And one last thing to end the presentation, we also have a free hosting program for open source organizations where we house young and popular open source projects, like give them a discussion space. So you just have to apply for that program. It's on our hosting so that these open source projects can find like a space for all their new users and get, so there are some limitations, like you have to be on our domain and stuff like that. But then again, there's, so that after you reach like a critical mass, then it changes. But right now, so we have some people in the room here too who have like been on our open source free hosting. I think the people at Chatwood had an instance. I don't know if they use it, but yeah. So yeah, if you just Google Discourse free open free hosting, you'll just find that blog post that says free hosting. And that's it. If anyone has any questions about working remotely or the software itself, please.
One second.
So we have a private instance at Zerodha, the intranet. I think Nitin posts there heavily. Like, it's not paragraphs, it's essays. So we're using it really well, 1,200. So you said that it's a recent trend, but does that make a difference to you? Is this some sort of a niche that you're going to focus on, or is it just incidental that people have started using it as intranet, you know, forums?
So the goal in 2013 was always to enable civilized discussion on the internet, but so it started out as a competitor to like old forum software projects. But as of today, we are seeing that tons of people are naturally using it in a teamwork context. So for example, Frappe here, you guys, and even our team, our team completely runs on Discourse. So it's happened naturally, but now that we've identified that fit, we've already added a lot of plugins and tools that let you move more of the teamwork stuff. So right now there's a plugin called Discourse Assign, which lets you assign topics out to people. So we use that all over. I don't know if we're doing a very great job of telling people that, oh, you can do this too. So I'm working on that. So if you didn't know about that, yeah, we've had that plugin for like 3 years or something. So we will work on that. But we have been building teamwork tools into Discourse for the last that's been one of our major goals in the last 2 years. So that's a direction we're definitely going in. We're also going to keep the old, the discussions exactly how they are, but we will be adding in these teamwork features. Yeah.
Hi, here. So we have a public Discourse instance. It's a managed hosting by Discourse. Yeah. So community.cleartax.in, right? Like many of your presentations, I think Jeff has talked about how it can become an equivalent of WordPress, right?
Yeah.
And somehow I have felt, it might be a wrong perception, that the plugin ecosystem is not as rich or deep. So are there plans, is it something that you acknowledge, and are there plans to improve that situation?
So we've been having internal discussions about this, that the you're talking about the meta, the plugin, the developer ecosystem, right?
Supported because plugins on managed hosting.
Oh, okay. The supported plugins on managed. So that's up from our hosting. So to be able to use your custom plugins on like the managed hosting plans.
Right, so in ability to extend and enhance.
Yeah, so I think like on the cheaper plans that I showed you, the standard and business plans, what happens is they're all clustered, so you can't really make exceptions. I think that's how the cost thing works. But on the enterprise plan and stuff, you can definitely add your custom plugins. We just have to talk. You just have to reach out to us, because that is that people are running their custom plugins on our hosting.
So again, the developer ecosystem, there are not enough plugins as you can find on WordPress.
Oh yeah, definitely. The WordPress example could be that we want to become a standard, but yeah, they have their plugin. We don't want our plugin system to become exactly like WordPress, because there are some problems on that side too. So we have to find a balance. But yeah, we have been talking about, why I can even say all this is because we have been talking about it recently. So we will be working on it. We will be improving it. Yeah.